I wish every Sunday is a fun Sunday. Good morning, we suffer. Happy Palm Sunday. I think everybody loves a parade. Anyone can be a bystander. It takes a little something extra to be a participant. 2,000 years ago, they gave Jesus a parade in Jerusalem, a city filled with bystanders. There were not many who were willing to participate in Jerusalem. The parade they gave Jesus was an insult. Today, dearly beloved, is Palm Sunday, and we are still haunted by those ambiguous feelings which have to do with triumph and tragedy, victory and defeat, honor and dishonor. Today is Palm Sunday, and we remember Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Today is Palm Sunday, and there is a crowd of people out there lining the streets to welcome Jesus to be King of the Jews. Today is Palm Sunday, and he comes riding into town on some young donkey like the old kings of Israel centuries before as they entered the holy city. Today is Palm Sunday, and some little boy who lives out in the country is the first one to come running barefoot into town to tell us the news. The King is coming. Jesus is coming down the road to Jerusalem. Today is Palm Sunday, and the King is coming. The King is coming, and no one can remain neutral. The King is coming, and someone must decide. The King is coming, and you must make up your mind about him. The King is coming, and we can no longer remain the same. Something has to change in our way of thinking. Something has to be different about our loyalties. Something has to be renewed about our commitment. Palm Sunday will not let us rest, will it? It always confronts us with a choice, for this King is coming to our city in our place and time. For over and over again, we are Jerusalem. So, on this Palm Sunday, I want to remind us of what is before us today. If we want to be spectators, palm waving, flag waving Christians who go home after the parade and forget it, then we can do just that. But let me warn you, if you are serious about Jesus, if you want to be a participant, then you better watch out and prepare yourself, because these things are before us this Palm Sunday. As we think about Jesus coming down the road to Jerusalem, will you be aware of these things? This King who is coming today to Jerusalem forces a desperate decision. That is one thing. No one can remain neutral about Jesus. We have to decide. To be neutral about Jesus is to be a Christian only in name. For many Christians today, church membership means no more than belonging to a club. They would rather be lukewarm than warm-hearted. They would rather save money than save the war. They would rather attend a Sunday brunch than a gospel feast. On that first palm waving day, Jerusalem was full of them, those people who lived their lives in neutral gear. But we cannot live in neutral gear. No one living in neutral gear ever moved forward, climbed a hill, or had a dream or vision. There comes a time for every person to make a decision. Palm Sunday is a reminder that Jesus confronted Jerusalem with a decision. And Palm Sunday means that Jesus confronts us with that same decision today. Some of us have a hard time deciding which crowd we want to be in. The large crowd of spectators who watch the parade, or the small crowd of participants who marched with Jesus. Someone once said, everyone wants to go to Rome to see where St. Peter is buried, but nobody wants to live like him. Many people would like to go to the Holy Land to see where Jesus lived, but so many people will not let him live in their heart. Almost every person in this country believes in God, but how many people really put God first in their life? Palm Sunday means Jesus confronts us with a choice, a desperate choice, a desperate decision, then something else. This king requires our dedicated devotion. If we make a decision for Jesus, then we are giving him our dedicated devotion. That is what it takes to be a Christian in today's world. It was that way from the beginning. Those 12 disciples were there with him. Jesus did not face Jerusalem alone. They were with him, not as bystanders, but as his loyal followers, willing to face Jerusalem with him. It is true, they did not understand all that was going on. It's true, they would not be able to stand up under the stress of that week. They would sleep, they would deny, betray, hide and lose their faith, but they were there, and they were devoted to Jesus. They dedicated their lives to him. That is what Palm Sunday requires of us. It is as difficult to be a Christian today as it has ever been. The followers of Jesus have always been a minority. We are a minority today. And there are so many things today which compete for our attention. Jesus offers the only alternative to the philosophy of a society gone mad over material things. Jesus has always been the center of our existence, which puts Christ and the kingdom of God above everything else. Jesus offered Jerusalem the choice on that first palm waving day. The choice is before us today. We can choose to be dedicated disciples who devote all we are to Christ and the kingdom. This king offers a dangerous destiny. That is the third thing. If we make a decision for Jesus and give him our dedicated devotion, then we are headed for trouble. It does not solve all our problems. It could create more. It does not make life easy. It makes some things more difficult. It does not make things simple. It makes something more complicated. It does not bring rewards and riches. It could cost us everything. It is dangerous to be a Christian. Jesus had spelled out what it means. He said, deny yourself, take up the cross and follow me. He had been telling the disciples all along that he was going to Jerusalem to face the cross, and there would be a cross also for all of them. As they got closer to Jerusalem, James and John came up to Jesus and asked for places of honor on his right and on his left. He assured them they would have a place, but it would not be what they thought. They would have to drink from the same cup from which he would drink. Their destiny as disciples of Jesus was to be a dangerous one. As Christians today, everything is not sweetness and light. We have a dangerous destiny. If we serve this King, we must be willing to give ourselves, take a chance, and never count the cost. God is calling us to be his witnesses in today's world, for there is no private Christianity. He's calling us to be servants, for there is no sideline Christianity. He's calling us to be his church, for there is no uninvolved Christianity. That is before us today. One day, one palm waving day, Jesus marched right into Jerusalem and said to everything unholy, stand aside. He is calling us to join him in that parade and to say to every form of hatred, of intolerance, of ignorance and indifference, stand aside. And when we dare to listen to Jesus, those things will stand aside. His kingdom will live in us, and we will help spread his rule in his world. Would you dare to do it? If yes, please come and join the parade. O God, our Father, on this Palm Sunday, as we come together, enable us to open our hearts and eyes so that you may come in and we may call from the depth of our being, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Help us open our lives to your Son. And during this week, help us remember all that he went through. Call us to watch and pray with him. We thank you, Father, for all the ways you bless us. For out of your abundance, we have received far more than we ever dreamed of. We have seen your hand at work in our life to bring good for us. Hope out of struggle, peace out of suffering, strength in the midst of our struggles, and the light of your love has been shining along our path. Grant us, Lord, some other blessings. Please give us patience with those who try ours. Help us to forgive those who would utter falsely against us. Help us love those difficult to love, because they are loved by you. Give us always the attitude of our Lord, who is bigger, better, and braver than his enemies. Bless our sick. Touch them as only you can touch them, and no man can. Touch their heart, for that is the healing they need. Give us peace and help us to be peacemakers. For Jesus said that we will be sons and daughters of you. We pray in the name of the Prince of Peace. Amen. Happy Palm Sunday. Eid of Eid for Hushan and Eid.
Everybody, good morning again. Happy Palm Sunday, and God bless you all. I would like just to thank Sayyidina and thank every one of you who came this morning, because the Palm Sunday really